All right, here we are for round number two. This hand is pretty mediocre, but just on the borderline of keepable, I think. With one scryland especially, I think we'll be able to find either a two or a three drop to play. So I'm going to keep it, even if it is very speculative. Alright, looks like another Jeskai or red-white deck. And fortunately, we have found a 2-drop. Ooh, Thoughtseize is perfect, too. A nice little proactive card for us. There's a Seeker. I think it's fine to take a hit from Seeker. See if we can get off a Thoughtseize because of it. So there's Ascendancy and Hordling Outburst. I think we just want to go ahead and take Ascendancy. It's the card that will let him filter through these cards, which are not that good. And we can have Bio Blight for the Outburst, so it should be fine. That's at least how I envision this game going. And I don't see any reason to let him untap with the Outburst worth of tokens. So let's just kill it now. Because he could do something like Lightning Strike one of the tokens that we target to fizzle our Bile Blight. I don't know if he would, but there's no reason to give him the option. Alright, so he drew another Ascendancy. It's definitely among his better options to draw. See if he's going to play that fourth land. Yes, indeed. So his hand is Lightning Strike and another land. Or Lightning Strike and an unknown, I think. Okay, well, let's go ahead and lay siege. And then we can hopefully raid up this Wingmate Rock. He'd have to cast two spells. We know he has a Lightning Strike. If he also has like a Sound the Alarm or a Raise the Alarm, it's pretty bad. Yeah, I think we just take this. Our guy is too valuable with Wingmate Rock in our hand. And if we get him to use up all of his spells, it's actually not that bad for us. So there's one down. Discarding a land. We got a 5. And the old post-combat Rabblemaster. Obviously required post-combat because he drew it off of the Ascendancy, so it's not actually that weird. But either way, I think we're safe to attack here and then play a Raided Wingmate Rock post-combat. I guess we could also just play Fleece Mane, but I think this is pretty safe. So we're dead to, like, Stoke or Treasure Cruise probably beats us, but I think we're beating most everything else. Yeah, he's just attacking with the goblin, which means he did not draw anything. So we can go ahead and crash in for 10. I think we want to hit for 10. Yeah, I think we definitely do. We're going to have 12 flying power next turn, so this also gains us the most life, which is nice. So if he drew a spell, we could be in a small amount of trouble. I think we just block Seeker of the Way. And then block Goblin here. Yeah, that sounds pretty reasonable. Idris Stoke. So that's not exactly lethal. Just means we have to block all of his guys, or block both of his big guys, which is moderately annoying. We do get to kill his Rabble Master at least, assuming he attacks with it. We go to two, but we have lethal on the crackback, so I'm a little confused by this. He must have some way, like a raise the alarm or something. But I still think we want to just see if he maybe made a mistake. Oh, we don't have lethal anymore. I'm so stupid. That's fine. We have a wingmate rock anyway, which is two creatures. I think I would still make this attack. I forgot he gained four life. But I would still make this attack either way. As it turns out, triple wingmate rock is pretty powerful. They fuel each other pretty nicely. Alright, no treasure cruise off the top. So, sideboarding. I like the glares, I like the drowns. Pretty much the same thing we did before. Don't like Hero's Downfall or Abzan Charm. Or Murderous Cut. And two Death Dealers. I think the Thoughtseizes are still good, even though they're an aggressively slanted deck, where sometimes you might think Thoughtseize is not good. I think they're still good in this matchup, because you want to snag cruises before they can really go deep. So, this looks good.